हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ए सीरीज ऑफ लेक्चर्स इन व्हाट टू रीड एंड हाउ टू राइट इन एग्जामिनेशन। टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज लिपिड मेटाबॉलिज्म। दिस इज ए इम्पॉर्टेंट चैप्टर फॉर यूनिवर्सिटी एग्जामिनेशन। दीज आर सम क्वेश्चंस, एलएक्यू मीन्स लॉन्ग आंसर क्वेश्चन, शॉर्ट आंसर क्वेश्चन एंड क्लिनिकल केस रिलेटेड टॉपिक्स। ओके, अब दिस ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन आर बीटा ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ फैटी एसिड, कीटोन बॉडी सिंथेसिस एंड इट्स यूटिलाइजेशन, फैटी एसिड सिंथेसिस, कोलेस्ट्रॉल सिंथेसिस एंड कोलेस्टेरॉल डिग्रेडेशन, लाइपोट्रॉपिक फैक्टर्स एज ए शॉर्ट नोट, फैटी एसिड सिंथेसिस कॉम्प्लेक्स, देन दिस केसेस, फैटी लिवर, एथरोस्क्लेरोसिस, लिपिड स्टोरेज डिसऑर्डर्स, ओबेसिटी, मेटाबोलिक सिंड्रोम and lipoproteinemias. These are important questions from this topic. We'll discuss this one by one. In beta oxidation of fatty acid, there is oxidation at beta carbon and there is sequential removal of two carbon fragment in the form of acetyl coenzyme A. This is known as beta oxidation of fatty acid. It has three important steps. First step is activation of fatty acid into acyl coenzyme A. This fatty acid is converted into acyl coenzyme A. There is difference between acetyl coenzyme A and acyl coenzyme A. Acetyl means it has two carbon. If there is more than two carbon, that fragment is known as, that fatty acid is known as, any fatty acid with more than two carbon is known as acyl. Okay, acyl coenzyme A. This step is known as activation of fatty acid. Then second step is transport across the mitochondrial membrane with the help of carnitine shuttle system. This is the second step. And third one is the beta oxidation proper. In this, oxidation, hydration, oxidation and cleavage, these are the steps. Activation of fatty acid, transport across the mitochondrial membrane by carnitine shuttle system, then beta oxidation proper. In beta oxidation, steps are oxidation, hydration, oxidation and cleavage, and there is generation of acetyl coenzyme A. Okay, if there is palmitic acid, it has 16 carbon, palmitic acid. Okay. It undergoes beta oxidation. It undergoes 7 cycles. 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th. 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th cycle. It undergoes 7 cycles. Okay. In this 7 cycle, there is generation of 7-FADH2. 7-NADH. And 7-acetyl coenzyme A by sequential removal of two carbon fragment, and last remaining one is the acetyl coenzyme A. So there are 8 acetyl coenzyme A which undergoes TCA cycle and gives 80 ATPs. Okay, energetics. It gives 8 acetyl coenzyme A gives 80 ATPs. This will give 7 into 1.5. That is 10.5. And this will give 7 into 2.5. That is 17.5. Means total 80 plus 17.5 plus 10.5. It is 108 ATPs, and 2 ATPs are utilized in the first step in the activation, minus 2. For energetics, 106 ATPs will be generated in the beta oxidation proper of palmitic acid. Got it? So in beta oxidation, you have to write steps of the beta oxidation, then energetics, regulation and disorders of beta oxidation, that is SIDS, sudden infant death syndrome. It is 10% cases of SIDS. They are due to deficiency of medium chain acyl-CoA dehydrogenase. Then Jamaican omitting sickness. It is due to eating of unripe ackee fruit which contain toxin hypoglycin A. And this toxin inhibits medium chain acyl-CoA dehydrogenase. That's why it affects the beta oxidation. Then alpha oxidation is also there. In alpha oxidation, there is oxidation of alpha carbon. There is removal of one carbon fragment sequentially. Alpha oxidation occurs in the brain in endoplasmic reticulum. And if there is a blockade in the alpha oxidation, that results in the disease that is known as Refsum's disease. Which is characterized by neurological symptoms and retinitis pigmentosa. Okay. This Refsum's disease is due to accumulation of phytanic acid due to deficiency of phytanic acid oxidase. So this is about the oxidation of fatty acid. Now second important question is ketone body synthesis. It is again a very, very important question. Ketone body synthesis, it is important in starvation and diabetes mellitus. Synthesis and its utilization. There are three ketone bodies: acetone, acetoacetate, and beta hydroxybutyrate. Of these, acetone and acetoacetate, they are known as true ketone body, and beta hydroxybutyrate, it does not contain keto group, it is known as false ketone body. But it accounts for 80% of total ketone bodies. So ketone body synthesis, it occurs in the liver, but liver cannot utilize ketone bodies because of absence of enzyme thiophorase. Ketone body synthesis, it is a very, very important LAQ. And there is YouTube video lecture available on this topic also. YT means YouTube. This topic, beta oxidation of fatty acid, there is YouTube lectures, ketone body synthesis, its utilization, there is lecture on YouTube, then fatty acid synthesis, cholesterol synthesis and degradation, there is lecture on YouTube. Okay, then fatty acid synthesis complex, there is lecture on the YouTube. Okay, so in ketone body synthesis, there is synthesis of ketone bodies, means acetone, acetoacetate and beta hydroxybutyrate occurs. Okay, of this, acetoacetate is a primary ketone body and acetone and beta hydroxybutyrate, they are secondary ketone bodies. The precursor molecule is acetyl coenzyme A. And main enzyme in this is HMG-CoA synthase for the synthesis of ketone bodies. And their utilization main enzyme A is HMG-CoA lyase, which is a main enzyme. Okay. So this is important, and it is important in starvation and diabetes mellitus. In starvation and diabetes mellitus, there is increased ketone bodies in blood, that is known as ketonemia. And its excretion in urine, it is known as ketonuria. Together, this condition is known as ketosis. Ketosis. As these ketone bodies are acidic in nature, they cause acidosis. Ketone bodies, they are acidic in nature, and to buffer this acidic nature of ketone bodies, the bicarbonate is utilized. That's why there is acidosis. This is known as ketosis. Okay. Then third important question in this chapter is fatty acid synthesis. This fatty acid and the first step in the fatty acid synthesis, that is regulated step, that is acetyl-CoA carboxylase, which is catalyzed by acetyl-CoA carboxylase, in which acetyl coenzyme A is converted into malonyl coenzyme. Okay, then through a fatty acid synthesis complex, there is generation of fatty acid occurs. Okay, for detailed information, please see the YouTube video on fatty acid, de novo synthesis of fatty acid. Then cholesterol synthesis, it has 5 steps. That the precursor molecule is acetyl coenzyme A, which is converted into HMG-CoA, which is converted into mevalonate. Then there is generation of isoprenoid units, condensation of isoprenoid unit causes synthesis of squalene and squalene is converted into cholesterol. In cholesterol degradation, cholesterol is utilized for steroid hormone synthesis. It is utilized for synthesis of vitamin D and it is utilized for the synthesis of bile acids. Cholesterol acts as a precursor for steroid hormone, vitamin D and bile acids. This is in the degradation of cholesterol. In cholesterol synthesis, HMG-CoA reductase is the main enzyme. Then role of adipose tissue in lipid metabolism. It is again important question. The hormone sensitive lipase is important here, which is activated by number of hormones and inhibited by the insulin. Number of hormone increases the amount of cyclic AMP. Cyclic AMP activates the protein kinase and this protein kinase activates the hormone sensitive lipase. And I will discuss this here. This is important role of adipose tissue is important. The main enzyme is hormone sensitive lipase. Okay. Now lot of hormones except insulin means glucagon, epinephrine, ACTH. These hormones, they activates adenylate cyclase and they causes conversion of ATP into cyclic AMP. Now this cyclic AMP activates protein kinase and protein kinase activates hormone sensitive lipase. This hormone sensitive lipase act on the lipid and converts the lipid triacylglycerol into free fatty acid and glycerol. Okay, this is the action of hormone sensitive lipase. And metabolism of lipoprotein, it is also an important topic. Metabolism of lipoprotein, metabolism of chylomicron, formation of LDL, formation of VLDL and formation of HDL. It is important topic. Okay. In metabolism, we will discuss two important things. First one is the reverse transport of cholesterol and role of LCAT. Okay. Reverse transport of cholesterol and role of LCAT. Of these all six questions, these four are very, very important questions. Okay. Now we'll discuss the reverse transport of cholesterol, role of LCAT, role of polyunsaturated fatty acid, and role of HDL. HDL is responsible for reverse transport of cholesterol. It is with the help of HDL, high density lipoprotein, through LCAT, lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase. What is the role of LCAT? LCAT, lecithin, it has PUFA, polyunsaturated fatty acid at C2 position. Okay, lecithin, it is a phospholipid, it has polyunsaturated fatty acid at the C2 position. This lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase removes this PUFA at the C2 position and it get attached to the cholesterol to form cholesterol ester. Now this cholesterol ester being hydrophobic in nature, this cholesterol ester, what is the role of LCAT? It transfers this fatty acid from lecithin to the cholesterol, leads to the formation of cholesterol ester in the HDL. And being hydrophobic in nature, this cholesterol ester moves to the interior of the HDL and now this nascent HDL becomes spherical with the help of this cholesterol ester. And this HDL is responsible for reverse transport of cholesterol from peripheral tissue. The cholesterol is taken from the peripheral tissue and it is transported to the liver for its metabolism. This is very, very important in VIVA, in theory also. Reverse transport of cholesterol what is the role of polyunsaturated fatty acid, what is the role of LCAT, what is the role of HDL in reverse transport of cholesterol. It is very, very important. Okay. Once again, I will... Once again, I will discuss this. There is generation of nascent HDL which is discoidal in shape. Okay. LCAT, ApoA1 which is present in HDL activates the LCAT, lecithin cholesterol acyltransferase, that catalyzes the transfer of PUFA from C2 position of lecithin to the cholesterol and leads to the formation of cholesterol ester. This cholesterol ester attached to the HDL and being hydrophobic, it moves to the interior of the HDL particle and now HDL particle becomes spherical and this cholesterol which is taken from the peripheral tissue, it is transported to the liver. That is known as the reverse transport of cholesterol. So these are the LAQs. In SAQ, lipotropic factor which prevents the formation of fatty liver, that is choline, betaine, inositol, B12, etc., methionine, etc. Then digestion and absorption of lipids starts from the mouth. There is lingual lipase, then acid stable gastric lipase, then pancreatic lipase, then intestinal lipase. Through this action of these lipase, these lipids are converted into free fatty acid and glycerol, monoacyl or diacyl glycerol. Then in absorption, there is micelle formation, digestion, role of bile salt is important. In absorption, there is micelle formation. Once it gets back into the intestinal mucosa, re-esterification occurs and their absorption into the lymphatic occurs. Long chain, very long chain, they absorb through the lymphatics, while medium chain, short chain, they directly absorb into the bloodstream. Fatty acid synthase complex, which is composed of 7 enzyme and 1 acyl carnitine protein, acyl carrier protein, okay, ACP. Then role of bile salt in digestion and micelle formation. In digestion, these are the lipid droplets, lipid aggregates, larger lipid aggregates. Now, in this lipid aggregates, this bile salt is amphiphatic in nature. Okay, it intercalates. Hydrophobic portion of bile salt intercalates into large aggregate lipids and converts these large lipid molecules into the smaller ones. These lipids are converted into smaller ones. Their surface tension decreases and their surface area increases. So more surface area will be available for action of lipase. This is the action of bile salt. We already discussed this, reverse transport of cholesterol. Then disorders associated with the fatty acid oxidation, that is SIDS, Jamaican vomiting sickness, Refsum's disease, Zellweger syndrome. These are the disorders associated, methylmalonic aciduria, these are the disorders associated with the fatty acid oxidation. The oxidation of odd chain fatty acid occurs in the same way as the even chain fatty acid. Only the end product will be propionyl coenzyme A. And this propionyl coenzyme A is converted into methylmalonyl CoA, which is converted into succinyl coenzyme A and enters the TCA cycle. So then these are the rare questions, synthesis and utilization of TAG, triacyl glycerol. Phospholipid metabolism, this is also a rare question. And eicosanoid synthesis means prostaglandin synthesis. There is YouTube video available on this topic, eicosanoid synthesis. See this video. There is a role of NSAID, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug in the eicosanoids. Then there is another drugs which can be used in the bronchial asthma. So inhibitors of this prostaglandin synthesis, they are important. Their therapeutic uses are important. Okay, so these are the rare questions, but it is easy to read. DHAP and glycerol 3-phosphate. Discuss in short, synthesis of phospholipid and TAG. This through glucose, there is formation of DHAP. And through glycerol, there is formation of glycerol 3-phosphate. Okay, these are interconvertible. Now, this DHAP is converted into lysophosphatidic acid, which is converted into phosphatidic acid. which is converted into diacyl glycerol, DAG, and it is converted into triacyl glycerol. DHAP is converted into lysophosphatidic acid, which has one fatty acid. It is acid which has two phosphatidic acid and phosphoric acid is there. DAG, it has OH group and two fatty acid, and TAG, it has three fatty acids. Okay, and this phosphatidic acid, it is a precursor for phospholipid. So these are the important questions from the LAQs and SAQs. Now two important questions we will discuss here. The first one is, why lipoprotein small a is dangerous? Lipoprotein small a, in bracket small a, it is atherogenic. It is also known as little rascal. It is atherogenic. Okay. It has significant homology with plasminogen. And it interferes with plasminogen activation. As it has homology with plasminogen, it interferes with the plasminogen activation. And it impairs fibrinolysis. It impairs fibrinolysis. This lipoprotein A impairs fibrinolysis. So there will be thrombosis. And patient is more prone for coronary artery diseases, myocardial infarction. Due to thrombosis, unopposed thrombosis. Lipoprotein small a. It is also known as little rascal. When the level goes beyond 30 mg per deciliter, it has significant risk of cardiovascular disorders. Okay. Again, we'll discuss one question. Why homocysteine is responsible for cardiovascular episodes? Increase in homocysteine interferes with the residues of collagen, and it interferes with collagen cross-linking. Okay, it interferes with the collagen cross-linking. And it is responsible for thiolation of LDL particles. It thiolates LDL particles, which engulfs by the macrophages by endocytosis, and this is responsible for plaque formation and atherogenesis. Okay. So this is increase in homocysteine causes cardiovascular episodes. These are the important cases: fatty liver, atherosclerosis, lipid storage disorders, obesity, metabolic syndrome, and lipoproteinemias. In this book, it is given. Okay. These are the cases. Fatty liver is discussed here. What is the meaning of fatty liver? Causes of fatty liver, cases, stages of fatty liver, treatment of fatty liver, and all. Names of lipotropic factors. This is a case-oriented approach in biochemistry. Then Refsum's disease, Jamaican vomiting sickness, Zellweger syndrome, cyanoderma. Atherosclerosis is discussed here. Steps in the atherogenesis or atherosclerosis is discussed here. Risk factor is discussed here. And these are the lipid storage disorders: Gaucher's disease, Niemann-Pick's, Krabbe's disease, Fabry's disease, Tay-Sachs, Sandow, metachromatic leukodystrophy, and Farber's disease. These are the lipid storage disorders. Okay, so this is all about lipid metabolism. Keep watching. Thank you.